गुड आफ्टरनून लेबर कमिटी इज जस्ट फेलिंग रेडिंग एमपी विक्टोरिया इन दिस आफ्टरनून वी हैव गैदर्ड हियर टू डिस्कस एंड आउटलाइन ए क्रिटिकल फ्यूचर एक्शन प्लान आई हैव टू से आई एम बिट reluctant to produce another set of recommendation and action. However, throughout the years, we have many policies and laws to protect the labor rights. We have a labor policy last update in May 2012. It promises a lot. Alas, 5 months after the policy was adopted, Darwin Fashions Limited caught on fire. Immediately after the Darwin fire, a national tripartite agreement was signed against with many significant promises. But as of now, none of the proposed action got implemented. Despite the agreement between BGMEA and the Bangladesh government, the collapse of Rana Plaza wouldn't have been prevented. Now, would it be an overestimate if I say there is no scarcity of labor policies, proposals, action plans for Bangladesh labor? Let me show give a few examples. There is some slides that main objective of the labor policy of Bangladesh is create an investment friendly environment in which workers' rights and dignity in secure. It is translated to Kamban Bengali. Apparel brands and retailers should aggressively continue implementing inspection and remediation program focused on fire and building safe in their suppliers, factories. Now I hope you would agree with me that these are just pages written with empty rhetoric. In the aftermath of each factory fire or a collapse, laws are devised, policies are drafted, however the ground realities remain the same. So, all the policies we live it through. So, I mean, no disrespect, or I am not questioning anyone's intention involved in the process of improving existing situation. I am only trying to draw our attention to the prevailing disconnect between the policy papers and ground reality. Let me give you two concrete examples. Globally and locally, we all know legal work hour is 8 hours a day. However, no government worker in Bangladesh works less than 11 hours a day. Average working day is 13 hours long, since minimum wage impossibly lower than living wage, workers are compelled to work overtime. As a result of long working hours, overtime workers develop different health problems. Very rarely you would find a garment worker above 40 years. workers very quickly lost their productivity. Therefore, a strict law of daily work hour became ineffective in practice. In aftermath of Tarbin fire and the collapse of Rana Plaza, a new multi minimum wage in proposed and enacted. However, talking to workers in Sabha this week, we have learned that workers are getting the same salary as they did before. An increase in monthly basic salary didn't change their monthly income. Factory management has figured out a way to manipulate the calculation by decreasing hazira bonus and overtime, etc. With this example, I have tried to explain why I am arguing our existing labor policies are just hybrid empty rhetorics. Unless there is a fundamental change in the way the factory owning, the ruling elites views the working class, no laws or policies could bring real change in the lives of our workers. Thank you.